In today's video, we're going to take a look at what's new with Safari with macOS Sequoia. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with Safari and macOS Sequoia. Let's go over to my Mac. Now, basically what Apple did is they redesigned the page menu. What do I mean by the page menu? Well, when you're on a web page, if you go up to where you type in the URL, the address, if we go over to the left of that, you're going to see we have this little icon here. This is the page menu. Now, this is nothing new, but they did redesign this, making it a little bit easier to access some of the features. So let's go ahead and click on this and take a look at some of these features that we have with Safari. So I click on it, it opens up, and then from here I can go and hide distracting items. I can zoom in and out. I can find something on the page. And then if I want to go to website settings, I also have website settings. And this will be specific settings for that web page. Also, there is a reader view here, but you're going to see that it doesn't show. Why not? Well, that's because I am not on a page that has an article. Reader view only works when you're on a page that is an article. All right, so that's basically the redesigned page menu. Now let's go through these features one by one. The first one we're going to look at is hide distracting items. Well, what is this? Well, basically what we're able to do is we're able to hide distracting items on the web page. As an example, there's this ad here right at the very top. This is a distracting item. I would like to hide it. Well, all you have to do is just go up to the page menu again. And then you click on Hide Distracting Items. It's going to put Safari into a special mode. And then from here, what I need to do is I just need to click on what I want to hide. So I'm going to click on this here. You're going to see that there's a blue border around it. So now I just click on it, and we can see it disappeared. Let's go ahead and hide this ad. Click on it, it disappears. Maybe I don't want to see buyer's guides. Click on it, it disappears. Now, when you are done, what we need to do is go out of that special mode. So I just go up here to where it says done. And when I do, it's going to apply those changes. Now, this also works great with Google login. We've all seen those websites where it asks us to log in with our Google ID. Maybe we don't want to do that. Well, that's a distracting item. So what you can do is you can go into that special mode, click on that Google login, and then just go and hide it. Now, if you want to show your items again, you can do that as well. If we go back up to the page menu, you're going to see that when I click on it, what I'm able to do is show the hidden items. So it doesn't remove them permanently, but it does remove them temporarily. So then you can go and show them. And then we also have zoom. We can easily zoom in and out of a web page here. And then if I want to find something on the web page, I can do that as well. Let's go into an article. I'm just going to click on this article here. And if I wanted to find a specific word on this page in this article, I'm not going to search the web. I'm just looking for something within the page. We can do that via the page menu. All I have to do is just go over to find here. And when I select it, I'm able to search for something within that web page. So it's not going to search the web, but it will search that web page. I'm going to click on done. If we go back under our page menu, you're going to see now that I am on an article, I can also show the reader. So what this is going to do is this is going to strip out the ads. This is nothing new. I just click on it and it shows the article without any ads. It's a great way to read an article. If I want to go back into the regular mode, sometimes it doesn't show all of the article. What you can do is just go back up to the page menu and then you just go to hide reader. But before we hide the reader, you're going to see that we have more options here. When I am in reader view and I'm under the page menu, I can change the background color. I can change the font. I can also change this text size. And I can find something on this page. So we can do this from within reader as well. I'm going to go back to hide the reader. And I'm going to show you a shortcut to entering reader view. Right now, what you need to do is you just need to click on this. And then you click on this, so it's two clicks. Wouldn't it be great if it was just one? We can do that. All you have to do is just long press on this, and when I do, it goes into reader view. I long press on this again, and it takes me back. So if you're on an article, it's just long press that. Now we also have, under our page menu here, we also have website settings. With this, what we're able to do is change the behavior of Safari based on the website. So any changes that I make here, use reader view when available, enable content blocking, all that is only going to be specific to Yahoo. If I was at CNN or another website, it would not use these if I were to turn these on. So these are website-specific settings. In addition to using reader view and enabling content view, I can also set the page zoom on a website basis. I can stop media with sound. I can block and notify pop-up windows. So I know in the old days, banks used a lot of pop-up windows. Well, if you have a site that uses a pop-up window, you can allow it on a specific site just by going over to our website settings here. And then I can also set a profile and I can set my permissions. Can this website, not Safari, but can this website use my camera, my microphone, screen sharing, and location? So these are website-specific settings. So that is the new page settings. But we're going to look at one more thing here, Apple Intelligence. When we're looking at an article on the web, what we're able to do is have Apple Intelligence summarize that article for us. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to turn on our Apple Intelligence. And you do need to have an Apple Mac with Apple Silicon. So I have a MacBook Pro M1 here, Apple Silicon. And what I'm going to do is go over to my settings here. And then you're going to see that I have an option for Apple Intelligence. I just select this and then I turn this on. Now, as of my recording, this is in beta, so you may not have access to this yet, but it is going to be coming soon. So I just turn this on. That's basically all I have to do. Now that it is on, when I go into Reader View, you're going to see I have a new option. So let's go back over to this article here, and I'm going to long press on this to go into Reader View. And then you're going to see Summarize. So this is Apple Intelligence. If I were to click on this, what it would do is it would summarize that article. I'd get a nice little summary of it, so I don't have to read the whole article. AI will summarize it for me. If it's a long article, what it'll also do over on the right here is it will also give me the different topics in that article. So then I can click to different sections within that article. So that's how Apple Intelligence works with Safari and macOS Sequoia. So that is what is new with Safari with macOS Sequoia. Basically, it's a new redesigned page menu. And then from there, we have easy access to our website settings as well as other settings, including Reader View. And if you use an Apple Intelligence, you also have access to summarization of articles. So that's what's new with Safari in macOS Sequoia. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, subscribe to my channel, or even share it with friends and family. Also, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. I have over 400 videos on YouTube, but on my site, danstutorials.com, I have over 2,100 videos. I've been doing this a lot longer on my site than I have YouTube. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, the site is a membership-based site. So when you become a member of my site, I take out all of the ads of the videos. You also have access to my classes and webinars that I hold on a regular basis. In addition to that, I also have an AI assistant that is modeled after an Apple Genius. You have access to that through Dan's Tutorials as well. And then you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house creating these videos, not part of some large corporation or anything like that. So your support directly benefits or helps me in creating these videos. Check out Dan's Tutorials for more information. And thanks for watching.